Good morning, students. So let us discuss the next part of the lesson from the diary of Anne Frank. The first part we saw why Anne Frank she started writing a diary, because she considered writing a diary is her true friend. Who considered Anne Frank? She considered diary is her true friend. So that's why she had many members in the family, almost 30, but it means no one was there with whom that she could confide, show the trust, that faith of sharing her own feelings, her own thoughts. So that's why she chose to write a diary. Later on, she defined her family background. And why we know that? Because she thought that nobody would be interested in knowing the things or reading the diary of a 13-year-old girl or a school girl. So that's why she gave a brief sketch of her family. So the next point, that Annie's schooling. Before that, both of them, who? Margot, her sister, and Annie, they stayed for a few days with their grandmother. When their parents, that they left for Holland, and later on both of them, first Margot and later next Anne Frank, that they went with to the parents. Anne's schooling, when they went to the parents to live there, that time Anne studied in the, first of all she started her education in Montessori nursery school. That she started until 6, that she studied there, and after that she started in the came in the first form, and till the 6th one that she studied at the same place. When she was going out, especially when she was in the 6th form, that time her headmistress was, that is given Mrs. Kupakas. The name of the teacher is given. She was a loving teacher and he liked her. So that's why at the time of farewell, especially when Annie was leaving the school, at the time of farewell, that was a heartbreaking farewell for Annie. Because why? Both the teacher Mrs. Kupakas and Anne Frank, both were in tears. Such kind of the attachment, affection was there. So this is what her schooling life, any schooling life, beginning, starting. Next coming, her grandmother's death. So next incident, which she has defined here, that is her grandmother. Because Annie, she loved her grandmother so much. There was an affection, close affection was there. Relationship was there between these two. So that's why clearly that she has mentioned, my grandmother, she fell ill in the summer 1941, and she had to be operated. Operation was there, she had to be operated, but that was not successful, and in 1942 that she died. My grandmother died in 1942. So that is why what happened, and she missed her grandmother so much. Who missed her? Anne Frank, she missed her. So that's why she was very close to her grandmother. So therefore, that she wrote in her diary, nobody could understand how much I love my grandmother. How much, the affection was there. So therefore, what she did, that she could not write a diary during that period, especially when her demise was there, death of the grandmother, she could not continue her diary. And also she could not celebrate her birthday, but in 1942, at the time of her birthday, what she did, Annie, due to the affection or love for her grandmother, she lit one more extra candle in the memory of her grandmother. Who did? Annie Frank, at the time of her birthday in 1942, in the memory of her grandmother, as a tribute, as the it means pay tribute to her that she lit one more extra candle in the memory of her grandmother. So that's why this is what we could say, that how much that she was close to her grandmother. So the next event is coming, her view about the teacher. So the next part starts, her view about the teacher. When the second part starts, that time Annie says the entire class was in fear. That was fear stricken. Why the entire class was in fear? That means was in fear, shaking with the fear, because tomorrow, it means forthcoming meeting. In the forthcoming meeting, teachers, that they were going to announce the result, that who, it means who would be in the next form and who would be kept back. So that's why everybody was concerned, worried that what would happen. And some of the students, they started making the bets, right? Started doing the making the bets in the form of money, etc. Even any some of the friends, that they almost invested their holiday, that whatever their money was there, that holiday money that they spent there, that sum that they spent on the bet. Everybody was in concern, in everybody was worried, thinking what would happen. Each and everyone was saying to each other that no, I am not going to pass that. Yes, you are. But no, once again that said, no, I am not going to go. It means I am not going to pass. Yes, you will do. It means you will pass. So in this way that everybody was doing. But here Annie, that she was not concerned. One more thing is given. Annie says that the teachers, but no one can convey. Annie was sure that we will definitely postpone, that we would be promoted in the next class, in the next form. She was sure, but she clearly, one statement, one quotation is given. What is the quotation? That the teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on earth. This quotation can be asked in the form of question, that listen again, the teachers are the most unpredictable creatures on earth. Why did she say? Because no one can say what would happen, what is in their mind going on. Especially one example is given, Mr. Kissing, the teacher, her maths teacher. Because she was not good at mathematics. Who? Any friend, not good at mathematics. So she says that the teachers are the most unpredictable. It means we cannot predict about them, about the teacher, what is going on in their mind. She was sure about the result, but still had a doubt. So that's why she quoted this here statement. And she was not good at mathematics any, but sure that definitely I would go in the next form, in the next class. So that's why she was telling to her classmates, her friends, not to worry. Still that she was worried, but telling her, everyone was supporting to each other, giving the moral support that don't worry, etc. So the next point, further, punishment by Mr. Kissing. Mr. Kissing is her mathematics teacher and she was not good at mathematics. Remember this thing, Annie Frank was not good at mathematics. She clearly defined that I had a good relationship with all the teachers. Annie had a good relationship with all the teachers except one. And you know, who is that teacher? Mathematics teacher, that is Mr. Kissing is the teacher. That. And one more thing, that he used to continuously, why? Because she disliked, she was not good at mathematics. So that's why whenever the mathematics class is going on, that she, that she used to go on talking. She, it means just like a chatterbox, that continues, she was talkative nature, having the talkative nature. So during the mathematics lesson class, that she used to talk. So that's why Mr. Kissing, the teacher, mathematics teacher, he gave many times he punished her. Who punished her? Teacher punished Annie Frank. Why? Due to her talkative nature during the class. First, for example, first the homework that he gave, as a matter of punishment. Punishment for what? Because she was talkative in the classroom, continuously used to talk and not good at mathematics. So the first homework that he gave as a part of punishment, that he told Annie that you write an essay on chatterbox. What is the topic of the essay? Chatterbox. Chatterbox we know, because she was talkative girl. So that's why, related with her nature, that he gave one topic, that you write an essay on chatterbox. Now Annie was confused what to write. And to remind her, what he did, that he kept the teacher one sheet there in her bag to keep her reminding. So Annie was confused that what to do. For example, the completion of the homework, that this topic was given, so how to write chatterbox, she was unable to understand. It's a very different, strange topic. So what to do now? She was in worried. But after thinking, after completion of other homework, other work, then she came, then she turned her attention to this essay. She had to write something, started thinking, musing over this thought, and at last he came to the conclusion that I have to write something different. That means, for example, something which is considered necessary, which shows the necessity, that she decided to write there. So that's why, something, because she come up with something convincing arguments. She wanted to give some convincing arguments this time in this essay, chatterbox. So that's why what she did, that she clearly defined. She wrote almost 3 pages for that essay. For that chatterbox, 3 pages that she wrote. And she clearly defined in the act, because in her essay, that speaking, for example, speaking during the class, it's a feature of the student. We cannot control, I am unable to control. Who said? Annie clearly defined in her essay that speaking during the class, talking during the class, it is a student's trait, student's feature. As a student, I cannot control. And second thing that she has defined, it is an inherited thing, inherited trait of the student, especially of Annie. Why? And she said that because my mother was talkative, as much as I, that my mother is talkative, so that's why the same trait, that that came to me. So that's why the two reasons that she gave, that it is a feature of the student, and the second reason that she, this is what the convincing arguments that she wanted to give this time. So that's why that she said that talking is a student's trait, which she would do her best to keep in control, under control, but that would never be able to do properly, because it is an inherited thing. She defined inherited trait. Why? Because I have received this from my mother. My mother is talkative, so that's why, she said clearly. Now when the teacher read her this essay, that time he read before the class. And he laughed too much, that he laughed then, and the class also laughed. But next time, one more, in the next class, once again the teacher found that she was talking in the class, during the lesson, during the teaching. And so that's why one more punishment the teacher gave, that this time, second time, that you write an essay, an incorrigible chatterbox. Incorrigible means the thing which we cannot cure, that we cannot control. So the teacher said that, Annie, that this time, Annie, you write an essay on an incorrigible chatterbox. Once again the same topic is coming, chatterbox. What to write? Already she had written 3 pages. So the same topic, this time also somehow that she wrote. But in the next third time, one more punishment is given by the teacher. He gave one more punishment, that this time, third time, that you write to Mr. Annie, that she said, Mrs. Annie, that she would write an essay that what? That Annie Frank would write an essay on quack, 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 said mistress, chatterbox. What is the essay third time? What is the topic given by the teacher for the third time? That this time, Annie Frank would write an essay on quack, 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 said Mr. Chatterbox. So any that she was confused, she was worried, concerned what to write, because all the three essays are depend on the same topic, same content. Almost her content was finished. So what to do this time? That was the question mark before in front of her. So this time that she took the help of her friend, Saini. The friend is given essay and any her school friend, and Saini, her school friend, that she was good in poetry, in verse, that she was good in poetry. Who? Her friend. So that's why her friend suggested her, Annie, that what you do, you this time write this essay in the form of a verse, in the form of a poem, that I would help you. So with the help of her friend Annie, that she wrote this time, but in the form of verse. And in that essay, that he mentioned one story, one short story, right? For example, three ducklings, that they died. For example, they died. Why? Because of the father duck beaten them, that she beat them. The father duck, he beat them. Why? Because they talked too much, quack, quack. In that story, that she has clearly defined, that what did she define in her story? That, for example, that about a mother duck and a father swan with three baby ducklings. A mother duck, father swan, and the three ducklings, and father beats them. For what? The father beats the three ducklings because that they quacked too much, they talked too much. So that's why she has clearly defined in her story. And when she presented the story to the teacher read before the class. He laughed too much. Not only that class, but also he read before the other classes also. All the other classes he read verse. But the matter, Annie was happy that he did not take it seriously. Because that was a kind of a humor almost there. That was a kind of a criticism Annie she made in a different manner. A kind of humorously that she wrote the poem. But Annie was happy that I am lucky that the teacher did not take it seriously. He took it lightly and he read the poem in front of the same class or other classes also, that he laughed too much. And but from that moment, one change that he noticed Annie noticed in his behavior, in Mr. Kissing's behavior, one change that she noticed. And what was that change? That from that moment onwards, that the teacher, he never assigned any homework to any friend. He never assigned any homework to her. Why? Maybe the reason would be different, that he might have understood the mentality of the child or the skill of the child, etc. So that's why from that moment onwards, he never asked her to write a homework on this and this topic. And he allowed her to talk. The teacher allowed her to talk in the classroom also. So that's why in this way, here is the end of the chapter from the diary of Annie Prang. So in these two video clips that in short that we have discussed about the summary, that actually why Annie Prang started writing diary. She considered diary is her true friend, best friend, with whom that she could share her feelings, her thoughts, all these things. She could keep her secret there. Next one that is given, her background, family background is defined. Her sister, parents, everything. Next coming, her schooling life, especially the primary school, nursery school, and Mrs. Kubelkus, the teacher, is given. At the time of farewell, heartbreaking farewell was there. Both were in tears. Next, her grandmother, very close, affectionate for her grandmother. And later on, about the teachers, especially Mr. Kissing, mathematics teacher. She was not good at mathematics. And so that's why the teacher punished her writing the different essays. Maybe first chatterbox, second topic, and incorrigible chatterbox. And the last, quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. And lastly, that reading that essay that he allowed her to talk. Right? So this is what, in short, here is the end of this chapter, chapter number 4. 4 from the diary of Anne Frank. So you write at your home each and everything, each and every word, because everything is not possible here to cover. So I hope that you understood it. At least the summary of this chapter. Here we will take rest, we will stop here. Thank you and have a good day.